Welcome back to the Savage Nation. We're talking about the a massacre at Fort Hood, where at least 12 people were massacred and at least 30 were injured. The suspected gunman is U.S. Army Major Malik Nadal Hassan. There are unconfirmed reports that Major Hassan was a convert to Islam. We'll be going to Representative John Carter in a moment. This just came into the Savage Nation. The Fort Hood shooting suspect, Major Hassan, is apparently a health professional, possibly an Army psychologist or psychiatrist. Officials say it was not clear what Hassan's religion was, but investigators are trying to determine if Hassan was his birth name or if he may have changed his name and converted to the Islamic faith at some point. We'll give you updates as they come. And let's go to Congressman John Carter, who was there when it happened. Congressman, thanks for being with us on the Savage Nation. You were right nearby, were you not?
Thank you. No, I had one of my personnel within hearing of the gunfire. He was on his way to his name is Greg Shanup. He's a former chaplain, chief of chaplains at Fort Hood. He retired and went to work for me. He was going to a graduation ceremony when the gunfire broke out. He actually talked to and assisted a wounded soldier who ran up to warn him that shooting was going on. And then Greg discovered the soldier had been wounded. So he actually saw and visited with a wounded and helped a wounded soldier. Then they put him inside of a building, and as far as I know, he's still inside that building because I haven't heard anything from him. We're trying to get
Congressman, we understand that one of the shooters was killed, Hassan, Malik Nadal Hassan, but that there were two others in custody. Do you know anything about their identities?
I do not, and I just received a communication from Fort Hood that the two that were in custody were released, that they were not, they had been identified by someone, and it turned out that it didn't work out. They were looking for another person, and then like almost 5 seconds later, we got a word they had caught that other person. So I assume they're questioning that person, too. But I have been informed, at least, that they released the two they had in custody.
And that I came see. So as of right now, we are to believe then that there was a single man involved, or there was one other man involved?
One other man involved. I think we've got a lot of unanswered questions, Dr. Savage. I really do. I think we need to be concerned about what we're going to learn through the night and tomorrow.
Yeah, absolutely. And there's no question about it. But, you know, people are asking, the first thing that enters their mind is, who would do a thing like this, and why would he do a thing like this?
Yeah, I just don't know the answer. I think everybody's reaction to start off with was it might have been a soldier who just had too much and cracked. But it didn't turn out to be that. This is clearly doesn't seem to be that. This seemed to be a deliberate attack. And we're now learning from Scott and White Hospital that there are several civilians that are among the wounded. I cannot tell you how many, but there are. It is being reported that civilians
I'm interested in what you just said. You said that it was not a guy who cracked, because what I've read is that he had not been to Afghanistan or Iraq. He was scheduled to deploy, but he had never gone there. So we can't say it's post-traumatic stress disorder if he had never been over there. So that leads you to the statement that it was a designated, desirable end that he was seeking. He wanted to kill people. Why was the FBI so quick to say it was not terrorism is what's going through my mind.
I've talked to someone who's dealt with the FBI in the past, and they said they're gonna say things like that, period, until this thing works its way out. It's their way of calming the waters now.
I understand. I'd like to calm the waters too, but I mean, you can make the waters so calm that people can drown to death. I mean, you don't want to put people to sleep. I mean, I'm not trying to pick a fight with you, Congressman, but this is very worrisome. If it looks as though it's an act of terrorism from a cell, a sleeper cell inside the military, I mean, we should know about it, all of us.
That's a horrible thought, and you know what? It's certainly not out of the realm of possibility.
And I'll let it go at that, and I don't want to press you on that. But, Congressman, thank you very much for taking the time to be with us on the Savage Nation.
Michael, I'm going to try to fly out of here early tomorrow morning and go to Fort Hood and then be back in time for this health care vote. But if I learn something more, we'll try to get in touch with you.
Well, thank you very much, sir. I really appreciate it. I do.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Well, there we are. There we are. So we the people are not supposed to use our own heads. We're supposed to rely upon officials. We're not supposed to think for ourselves. We're supposed to tune into, the Yankees. Well, wait a minute. What's going on in the baseball world? Yes, the little people should be concerned about baseball and getting vaccinations. And by the way, speaking of vaccinations, where are they? Now, I remember that when George Bush was blamed for an act of God when Katrina came and hit the levees in New Orleans, the libs wouldn't stop blaming him for an act of God. They didn't let it go. He did it specifically to hurt minorities. Now we have Barack Hussein Obama, the perfect man, the anointed one, the prince of all. And the man can't even produce enough vaccine through his health departments, through his workers. There's not enough to go around. Why is that? This, to me, is a national travesty. It's a travesty. And he's getting a pass on it. Now, you know that if McCain were in office and there was only enough for 12% of the population, they'd be screaming Republicans are incompetent. It's Katrina, too. Jesse Jackson would be on his broomstick along with Al Sharpton trying to agitate the people into some kind of situation down there, in my opinion. But now, of course, we the people sit here and just swallow it. Bakersfield, Gene, you're up on the Savage Nation. Go ahead, please.
Yes, Michael. You asked the question, is it relevant that this person is, this major, is a convert to Islam? And I think it's extremely relevant. I'm a retired Marine and a prison chaplain, and I had a man who was a born in Iran and was Islam all of his life. He's in his midlife now, and he came to my services for about 9 months and converted to Christianity. And after his conversion, I asked him, I said, is it true that the Quran teaches that you are to proselytize and try to convert people to Islam, and if they fail to convert, that means they're the infidel, and you are to kill them? And he said, that's exactly what it teaches. And so I think our country is very naive to think that this doesn't have relevance.
Well, my friend, the retired Marine and current chaplain in a prison, I'll let it go at that. You said exactly what needs to be said. 1-800-449-8255. And by the way, there's a caller from Chicago who has a very interesting point that the police, it was the local police who came in and killed the shooter. Incidentally, it was a SWAT team, and one of the SWAT members got killed. It was not the military police who stopped this carnage. That's interesting. The men were unarmed, by the way. Why were the soldiers unarmed? I have a question for the audience listening to this show right now across America. Do you believe this was a terror attack, yes or no? Do you believe this was a sleeper cell inside the military, yes or no, and why? New York City, WOR, Tony, go ahead, please.
Hey, Michael, it absolutely was a terrorist attack. And what's incredibly frustrating is I happened to be off today. I was watching it unfold on the news, and they just will not acknowledge at this point that this is what it is. There's this fear, and they interviewed Senator Hutchison, and one of the correspondents said, is it possible that this is terrorism? And her exact quote, as I watched it, was, that's way too speculative. And it just made me sick.
Well, she's worthless. She's another Arlen Specter rhino, absolutely useless in my opinion. I don't know which politician will actually speak the truth today with regard to any subject, let alone this subject. So I wouldn't have expected anything more from Hutchison. But she is not the issue. The issue is the American media. The issue is what you, the American people, think. Because as far as I'm concerned, I could care less what the officials say. I could care even less what the media says. I only care what the American people think. That's why I am in talk radio. It's our country. It is not owned by the media. It's not owned by the government. It's owned by the people. Never forget that. And I'm going to tell you something else. Here's something that you remember from the 70s if you're around. When the leaders refuse to lead, the people must lead the leaders, and you better start leading these psychos in Congress. Here you have a moron, a nutcase, a psychopath in Congress who didn't get it. You got a Republican winning in Virginia by a landslide, a Republican winning by a landslide in New Jersey, and she says the next day, the official talking point from Psycho Babbleville is we won because of a district in upstate New York. We won, and the American people want Obamacare. Have you ever seen anything like this? In the very same day, a radical group of senators passes a global warming bill in committee. The very same day, the radicals on the Judiciary Committee take out an essential tool of the Patriot Act that would have permitted this government to continue to run surveillance on non-citizens. Do you understand what's going on here? Do you understand that liberalism is a mental disorder? Do you understand that we're all in danger because of it? Do you understand these men are dead because of liberalism? I'll tell you like I see it. And I don't care who doesn't like it. These men are dead because of liberalism. Because if we had lived in your father's time, I can guarantee you as I stand here that Major Malik Nadal Hassan would not have been able to blow these people away. That's all I'm going to say right now. And I'm going to take a break before I say something I really regret.